Thank you so much. Sorry for being delayed for the presence. Dear lecturers and students, it's a great pleasure for me to participate in this highly interested student conference. My name is Abdul Wahab, and the title of my research is The Critical Analysis or Examination of Literature Around the Political, Economical, Social Impacts of Colonialism and Imperialism, Indian Crescent as two different case studies. It's supervised by Mr. Siyako Suleiman. I'd like to thank to him for all the preparing research. Colonialism and imperialism are two different phenomena. Colonialism is the implanting of settlement on a distant country or territory, but imperialism is the policy of extending a country's power basically through colonization. Simply, colonialism is a form of practice, but imperialism is the idea of driving this practice. If we analyze the colonial and imperial situation of Britain, we can say in 1615 it was just a simple island, but 300 years later they became the ruler of a quarter of the whole globe. The main reason behind the improvement was their supreme navy and strong diplomacy. British Empire consisted of the colonies, dominions, protectorates, and other territories which ruled by under the United Kingdom. There is no doubt that India is much influenced by the British rule in their own country. Britain exploited their natural resources such as coal and other natural resources which decreased in the economy of India. Another influence on culture and education was Thomas Macaulay's ideas on a minute on education. He tried to impose the British education system in Indian culture. He says that it's crucial to create a class to interpret between the people whom we are governing. Therefore, they much influenced the Indian education. In a matter of fact, Britain westernized India. Of course, decolonization, how did India decolonize? British, in a great extent, helped India to decolonize. Decolonization means the achievement of independence. The mutiny of 1857 is the turning point of Indian nationalist movement. But another case was education, which the Indian Western educated people. Western education influenced Indian people in a way that even Britain could not imagine. They used the ideals of such John Locke and Adam Smith, philosopher of the liberalism and democracy. At the end, with the policy of Gandhi and Nehru, they gained independence in 1947. If we come to the British imperialism in Kurdistan, we can say the beginning was the only reason was to keeping India safe from a potential threat of other nations. They wanted to create a country, a state to protect India from their own enemies, Britain. The Second Plan of Sykes-Picot Agreement was another case. We can say it was the beginning of British imperialism, which Britain diplomat Max Sykes and French diplomat George Francois Picot negotiated with the consent of Britain, Russia Foreign Minister Sazanov. Then on 16th of February 1916, they agreed on the division of Ottoman Empire. According to the map, if we combine the Kurdistan map to their own original Sykes-Picot agreement, we can say that they divided Kurdistan into three different parts. The north part was for Russia, the west part for France, and the southern part for Britain. I will examine this situation and also the current situation of this Britain's policy in Kurdistan. Yesterday, as you all know, we marked on to 100 years of the signing, since signing the Sykes-Picot Agreement. From that time till now, the conflicts in the Middle East are still continuing. The national borders, as you see before, were irresponsibly and arbitrarily drawn and caused to treat the whole region into a chaos. We can say the source of conflict is European imperialist policy, for failure of policy, not ISIS, because ISIS doesn't exist in 100 years ago. If we examine the British imperialism in Kurdistan, in 1918, Ottoman Empire ended its rule in South Kurdistan. Therefore, in British imperialist try to construct an Indian administration to make Kurdistan or the whole region as a colony. They used the administration of dividing and ruling, just like India. Therefore, they promised Kurdish leaders such as Sheikh Mahmud Barzanji to create an independent state. They made him to governor of Kurdish territory. But when Mahmud Barzanji demanded its rights and creating independence, an independent state, they restricted the authority of Sheikh Mahmud Barzanji, therefore he rebelled. There are two different rebellions, one of them is 1919 and the other one is 1923. Between two different times, the hypocrite policy of Britain and Turkey caused it to division of the Kurdistan. Of course, when those events were happening, there was a straight reflection on literature. I have taken the example of Fahd Bekas's famous poem called "It's Been 27 Years" to show the bitter reality that British imperialism has never wanted to an independent state. I will read it in Kurdish language, therefore if you want to get the English meaning, there is translation. It says, "Bistuhat salamin rajveritum, banano awajru bergihum, khismatun kildila iran rum. لپیناوی تو شکاوه استم که چی هشت هر دیر و رنجرم." The ideas is expressed in a creative way. Firebakers tried to show the bitter reality of the British imperialist. He meant that although Kurds remain loyal to the Empire of Britain, but they never wanted to establish a Kurdish state. Of course, when we think about independence, nationalism is the only reason that a country will create an independent state. According to the dictionary, nationalism is a desire of a large group of people, especially the people who share the same culture, language, history, to create an independent state for their own benefit, on benefit. I've taken the Memuzin example as Kurdish nationalism. I think most of you know the true story behind the epic of Memuzin. It's the true story of two young lovers called Mem and Zin. In the epic, the love of them is representing, symbolized to a strong desire of Kurdish people to create an independent state. Mem is representing Kurdish people, and Zin is representing Kurdish country. Ahmadi Khani tried to create a good image of nationalism to show people that we can create our literature and reflect our national values and ideas. What is significant with Mademoiselle? The main point which concerned me is the, it's written in Kurdish language, which was really rare at that time. 300 years ago, all the piece of works were written in Persian, Arabic, and other languages. But Ahmad Khali used in Kurdish language just to show the neighbors the existence of the Kurdish language. According to the Dutch Brynäs, the Dutch anthropologist, some certain verse of this epic is reflecting the same ideals of the 20th nationalists. These both verses are entitled under the Derdimme, which means our concern. He clearly and wisely expressed the problem of Kurdish society. I will again read in Kurdish language and would like to express the whole idea. It says, ما اتفاقك فكرة بكرة مع قيادك تكميل ذك المدين ودولة تحصيل ذك المعلم وحكمة تمييز دبون جهة ومقالات ممتاز دبون خدام كمالات روم وعرب وعجم توامي هميان جمارة ذك الخلامي أحمد خاني wanted to emphasize the unity of the Kurds, which is the main reason to establish an independent state. He says if we can create a unity among our society, we can establish an independent state. Therefore, it will create a positive atmosphere, a good environment to improve cultural and social values of a country. We can choose the talented people, talented new generation, so as to make society strong from the ambition of the other invaders. In conclusion, I came to the conclusion that Britain had a great direct impact on India and indirectly affected Kurdistan's future. It also helped development of India, but in Kurdistan they used the Kurds for their imperialist policy for their own benefits. They imposed English language to Indian culture, therefore they created a oneness among the society, but in Kurdistan they agreed on the division of lands throughout the Sykes-Picot Agreement. And also, I think Kurdish teachers have good examples of expressing the circumstances of that happened in the throughout the history. Thank you so much.